الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we were in the صفات التي لا ضد لها، and we said they are how many? Seven. They are how many? They are seven. And we have already taken how many? Three. We've taken three. We haven't taken this one yet. So we've previously taken how many? Three. And today we're going to start with the fourth one, inshallah ta'ala. Does anyone remember the first one that we did? The first one was As-Safir. You see, now your tajweed has to be good. So As-Safir, the way you say it. And the second one was what? Al-Qalqala. And the third one was what? Al-Inhiraf. We did Al-Inhiraf. So today we're going to do Al-Lin. What does Al-Lin mean in the Arabic language? What does Al-Lin mean in the Arabic language? Meaning, what were the Arabs calling Al-Lin before Islam came? What was it before Islam? It meant as-suhula, ease. Ease. Suhula means what? Ease. Simplicity. Easy. Simplicity. Like easy. Yeah. Simplicity. So what is the word as-suhula, what does it mean? Simplicity, easy. Okay, that's what it means. The scholars of Tajweed, Ahlul Quran, and the people of Tajweed, what do they understand? And what do they mean by it? They mean khurujul harf. The letter, it comes out. Min makhrajihi, from its what? From its position, from its place. Fi leenin wa yusrin. Am wa suhula. It comes out, the letter comes out with ease and simplicity. The letter comes out with ease. Like, easy. Simplicity. Do you know what simplicity is? When something very simple. Simple. Ease and simplicity. No, adamul kulfa. There's no hardship. You don't have to, huh? There's no hardship. What letters are they? They are two. And wo and? Wo and? Wo and ya. The wo is sakina. It has sukoon on it. Al maftuha ma qablaha. And there's a fatha before it. Well, yeah. Yeah, we're going to give examples, inshallah ta'ala. But first is al-waw. Are we all together? It's what? Waw. Has sukoon on it. And it's maftuha what? What before it is what? So it's sukoon on top of the waw. But before it is a what? There's a fatha before it. Al-maftuha ma qablaha. Second one is what? Wal-ya as-sakina. Ya da has a what? As-sukoon on it. Al-maftuha, and it's got fatha on what? Ma qablaha, that before it. Does that make sense? So it wal-ya as-sakina. It's a ya da has sukoon. Al-maftuha, and it's what? Fatha, the letter before it. Sababu tasmiya. Why was it called Al-Lin? Why was the ya as-sakina al-maftuha ma qablaha? And the waw as-sakina al-maftuha ma qablaha? Why was it called Al-Lin? Why? What was the reason? The reason is because li khuruji harfayha, the two letters, harfayha, they come. The exit of the two letters is what? Bilinin wa suhula. ease and simplicity. Jazakallahu khairan, Unais. With ease and what? Ease and what? These letters, they come out with ease. Adamul kulfa. There's no hard work that the person has to come with. Easily the person can say it. Easily the person is able to say it. At-takrir. What does at-takrir mean? Lughatan, it means al-i'ada, repetition. 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 To repeat something. Repetition means what? To repeat something. Lughatan, what does it mean? It means al-i'ada, to repeat something. At-takrir means what? To repeat something. That's what it means in the Arabic. That's what it means in the Arabic language. That's what it means in the language. In the Arabic language. Istilahan, what does it technically mean? Everybody listen. It means irti'adul lisan. The trembling. Irti'ad means what? The tongue, it trembles. عند النطق بالحرف, when the word is articulated. Listen now. ارتعاد اللسان. ارتعاد means what? Tremble. The tongue trembles when you are articulating the letter. Huh? ارتعاد means trembling. When articulating. Okay, when pronouncing the letter. Easier. Yeah, Abdullah. Sir? Are we all together?
Yes.
ارتعاد اللسان, the trembling of the tongue, عند النطق بالحرف, when we what? When you pronounce the letter. And how many letters?
One.
Which one? Which one is it? الراء. حرف واحد هو الراء. الراء. What happens to the راء? Yeah, it's a harf of tikrar. سبب التسمية. Why was it called? سبب التسمية means what? Why was it called? التكرير. Why was it called التكرير? لارتعاد طرف اللسان عند النطق بحرفها. The reason why it was called is the tip of your tongue. طرف اللسان means what? The tip of the tongue. The tip of the tongue, it trembles when pronouncing this particular letter. What happens? It trembles, trembles. Does that make sense? The tongue, it trembles. What does it do? The tip of the tongue, it trembles. عند النطق بحرفها, when you are pronouncing the what? This letter, which is what? الراء. It's the tip of the tongue trembles when you articulate this letter. Everybody here, pay attention. التفشي. What does التفشي mean لغةً in the Arabic language? الانتشار means to spread. Spread. When something spreads, what is it called? التفشي. تفشي. التفشي means to spread. Okay, when something goes all over the place, what is it? It means الانتشار. Like for example, انتشر الأخبار. The news spread. Are we all together? So التفشي means when something spreads. Okay, so why? What is it called in the technical language? Sorry, what is it in the language of the, yeah, the scholars of Quran? What do they do with the word? They said it means انتشار الريح. The air spreads. في الفم, in the mouth, inside the mouth. The air, what does it do? It spreads inside what? The mouth. عند النطق بالحرف. When you are what? When you're articulating the word. حتى يتصل. until it connects to بمخرج الضاء, until it connects to the what? It comes so close to the مخرج الضاء. Are you with me? What does this exactly mean? You're going to have to take it from your teacher, inshallah ta'ala. He's going to give you the practical examples, okay? So what does it mean? It means انتشار الريح. Then it's that the air spreads in the mouth عند النطق بالحرف, when you pronounce the word, حتى يتصل بمخرج الضاء, until it connects to the مخرج of the ضاء. What is its letters? حروفها. What is this? Which letters from the alphabet? حرف واحد, which is الشين. It's how many letters? Which is الشين. سبب التسمية. Why was it called التفشي? What was the reason? Why was it called? Why was it called التفشي? لانتشار الريح. The reason why it was called it is because انتشار was the language, right? So why was it called? The air spreads in the mouth when you articulate the مخرج, the word. Ha. انتشار الريح. The air spreads في الفم, in the mouth, عند النطق, when you pronounce the letter. When you what? When you pronounce the letter. We have one more to do, inshallah ta'ala, and we're going to do it today. So next week we can start الصفات العارضة الاستطالة. الاستطالة is the last and final one. الاستطالة means الامتداد. In the Arabic language, what does it mean? What does الامتداد mean? It means to lengthen. To lengthen. To prolong. It's to prolong something. Make it long. اصطلاحا, what does it mean? So الامتداد, that's what it means. مد, you know what مد is? امتداد comes from the word مد. مد means what? It's to make something long, right? اصطلاحا, what is it? It means امتداد الضاد. What do? Lengthening the ضاد. في مخرجها. From what? From its place it comes out. And where is it? من أول حافة اللسان. The edges of the tongue until the end. So what does it do? You prolong it. You lengthen the articulation of the ضاد from where? في مخرج. When it comes out, you do it. نعم. So simple terms is the prolonging of the مخرج of what? ضاد. That's in simple terms. حتى تتصل بمخرج اللام. Until it what? It connects to the مخرج of the لام. How many حرف is it? How many حرف is it? It's only حرف واحد هو الضاد. It's only ضاد. الاستطالة is only what? الضاد. Why was it called الاستطالة? Why? The reason is because الاستطالة حرفها وامتداده في مخرجها من أول حافة اللسان إلى نهايتها. From the minute you articulate the ضاد until the ending, you are what? You are prolonging your tongue. Look at the ضاد. It's all of it. It's all of the side of the tongue. From the beginning of the tongue to where? So it's not connected only to the tip of the tongue or the ending.
Could you repeat
the سبب التسمية is the prolonging of the letter ضاد. It's the prolonging of the letter ضاد من مخرجها, from where it came out. That's what it means. And that's why it was called استطالة. That is why it was called الاستطالة. That is why it was called استطالة. بحمد الله ومنته. With the praise of Allah and His grace, we have finished We have finished the sifat lazima. We finished. We divided sifat lazima into two types. The one is sifat dhatul dhid, and the other one was sifat التي لا ضد لها, صح? We finished that or did, how many was it? Five. And the الصفات التي لا ضد لها, we said it how many? سبعة. Seven. And we've taken it all. ولله الحمد والمنة. Inshallah ta'ala, in our next lesson, we're going to start صفات عارضة. صفات عارضة. And we will know what is meant by the author, Imam al-Jazari rahimahullah, when he mentions حق الحرفي and the مستحق, أما مستحق الحرفي, أما مستحق of the حرف. وهو إعطاء, what did he say? وهو إعطاء الحرفي حقها من صفة لها ومستحقها. We will learn that inshallah ta'ala. Next lesson. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.